Favorite saxophone channel. It's Saturday saxophone tutorials again. Last week we were here and we started a class on how to make your saxophone tone sound like a pro, how to make your saxophone tone sound like a professional. However, we weren't able to complete that class because it was a lengthy one last week, so this week we'll be having a part two of it. We want to complete it this week, how to make your saxophone tone sound like a professional. I want to say, if you missed that class, please check on the playlist Saturday saxophone tutorials. We have the video there, you can watch it, and so that you join us on what we want to do for today, so that there will be a continuation. All right, for last week we looked at posture, we looked at the right mouthpiece and not the saxophone itself. We also looked at embouchure and we looked at breath support, breath control, the diaphragm. As a matter of fact, all of these things I've mentioned, they are very, very vital when it comes to getting that professional tone. Okay, let's go into the business of the day. Today we'll be looking at tonguing. Yes, tonguing. Now, which brings us to articulation. There is no way you want to play and get that professional tone without you engaging your tongue. You just have to engage your tongue. Which type of articulation do you want to play at every given time? Is it legato soft tonguing? Is it staccato? Or is it pure legato? Is it back tonguing? Is it double tonguing? Is it triple tonguing? You just have to, you know, decide what you want to do at every point in time in order to help you get that jazzy tone, help you get that saxophone, you know, a professional tone. Okay, like I said, tonguing. You just have to engage your tongue. Today we'll be playing on B flat. We'll continue on B flat. And let's just say. You see that my tongue was just, you know, hitting the notes. It was not just pure legato, it was more of legato soft tonguing. That's how it is. You just have to engage your tongue. If you don't engage your tongue, you might not have that win-win sound. No? Let's say without the tongue, something like. Of course, that's a nice sound. But it doesn't sound jazzy. Yeah, it doesn't sound jazzy. It's not more of a professional sound because my tongue was just dormant. Okay, now let me jazz it up and, you know, put more of tongue in the song and let's see how it goes. Yeah, so that's how it is. You just have to engage your tongue. You just have to engage your tongue. Okay, the second one for today, in order for you to get that professional tone, is vibrato. vibrato. You just have to add vibrato in whatever you want to play. You know, you have to add it, you know, not just all through vibrato, just, you know, some of the notes, most especially towards the end. That is where you add vibrato to your play, like. Now, it has to be a conscious thing. Play your vibrato consciously. You know, be sure that on this note, I want to play vibrato. Add it consciously. Okay, let me jazz it up. So you can see that vibrato is also playing a major role when it comes to, you know, that professional sound, that professional tone. You can't do it without vibrato. Very, very important. And the next one for today is note bending. You want to play that professional sound, you want to play with that jazzy tone, you need note bending. Now, you know, my tongue was active, the vibrato was there, and you see some of the note bending. You can't do without it. You know, when you play, try as much as you can to, you know, bend some of the note. All right, I think let me just digress and tell us something about vibrato. For vibrato, what happens in vibrato is more of the lower lip, the pressure with the reed and your lower lip. That's what happened. You know, for vibrato, some people play wah 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 wah. The syllable you are supposed to use is wah 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 wah. For me, I play with ya 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 ya. So it all depends on you, the one that suits you. But what we are looking at actually is the tension between your reed and your lip, you know, back and forth movement. It goes like this, wah 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 wah, a frequency like movement like this, wah 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 wah, your lip against the reed. So that's for vibrato and note bending. They are almost the same. For note bending, you bring your lip down a bit and take it back. Ta, ta, ta. So that's for note bending. Okay, the last one is actually dynamics for today. Dynamics. Now, for dynamics, simply means how high or how low you are playing a phrase or a passage or some notes in the music. How high or how low? Like. That's just it. Dynamics. Yeah, dynamics. All right. I want to believe you've learned something today again. Just stay with us on this channel. By next week, we'll be looking on how to play grace notes on the saxophone. How to play grace notes on the saxophone. That's a technique, you know, a major one that you also need as a sax player. So by next week, we'll be looking at how to play grace note on the saxophone. Please, if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing to the channel. Just click on the subscribe button and click on the bell beside the subscribe button so that you get notified once we upload our saxophone tutorial. I want to say thank you for this far. Thank you for staying with us up until now. Thank you for watching. God bless you and see you next week. Thank you.